You're watching the new My Territory.
And good morning, South Florida. Good to be with you as always this morning. I'm Danielle Knox.
And I'm George Estevez. Thank you for starting your week, really, watching My 33 News on the Move. Mm-hmm. So let's get you some headlines right now. First up, you're feeling it if you're heading outside. Temperatures have taken a tumble overnight, making this one of the coldest mornings of the year.
And as the temperatures drop, we have some safety tips for you. I'm Nefertiti Jacquez, live on South Beach, where it's pretty cold. I'll have that story coming up.
Then, first on 33 this morning, the diesel springs into action. What the honorary police officer did when he became the victim of a hit and run.
And we're counting down to a Super Bowl showdown right here in South Florida. From the exclusive parties to the team arrivals, we have everything you need to know to navigate to the big game.
Feeling a little groggy this morning. The breakthrough doctors have made and the mission to help you get your Z's.
Plus, we are dishing up the dirt. Could it be a preview of things to come? We'll tell you who walked away with a win at the SAG Awards.
So wake up, South Florida. My 33 News on the Move, getting your day moving on this Monday.
Now, live, this is My 33 News on the Move.
It is 7:01. It's Monday, January 29th. Thank you so much for joining us right here on South Florida's hottest morning newscast.
Yes, starting off the week, Craig Setzer is in for Pamela Wright to get things started, which is a good thing, Greg, because you brought the cold weather with you, really.
Yeah, you know, I'm a big fan of the cold weather, and whenever I show up and visit you guys, I just want to help cool everybody down. And that's what we're looking at this morning. Temperatures in the low to mid-50s in Broward for current readings, and in Dade, pretty much the same story, low to mid-50s, even some upper 40s outlying sections, but it's going to get colder yet. This isn't the coldest of what we've seen from this latest cold front that pushed through yesterday afternoon. The cold front came on through and has allowed the cool air to spill in. It's also very dry, so fire danger is going to be high for today. And tonight, it's going to be even colder. In fact, look at some of these lows. Forecast lows tonight, 40 in Margate, 43 Oakland Park, 44 in Hollywood, a 39 in Weston, and there's even a freeze watch in effect for the Everglades portion of Broward County. Now, that should be west of the metro areas, but we may even see some patchy frost in outlying parts of the metro areas. Pretty much the same story also for Dade, temperatures in the 30s and 40s for overnight lows, so it's going to be a colder night tonight than we saw this morning. Here's our forecast for today. Call it Sunshine City with a chilly start. High temperature near 66 degrees. It'll feel good in the sun, but not so good in the shade. Now, let's look at traffic. Here is Mark Henry.
Hey, thanks a lot, Craig. Well, things getting a little bit stacked up out there right now on 95 north and southbound right around Cypress Creek Road. A little bit of a heavy ride coming out of Pompano right now. If you're heading southbound, you're probably going to be definitely hitting the brakes around Commercial Boulevard area. Northbound lane's not doing too bad. Going to get a little slow around Atlantic and Sample, but other than that, not a bad ride there. Also taking a look at 95, north and southbound around the Golden Glades. Heavy commute right now if you're heading southbound between 151st and 62nd Street. Definitely want to give yourself an extra few minutes, maybe even think about 441 as your southbound alternate. Now your northbound lane's getting by without too many problems at all, and the Dolphin eastbound lane's definitely getting real heavy as you approach Milam Dairy Road in the Palmetto area. Westbound lanes, though, getting by without too many problems at all. Live from Traffic Control, I'm Mark Henry, My 33 News on the Move.
Thank you, Mark. It's 7:03. I tell you what, winter may have come late to South Florida, but it is definitely here now.
Better late than never, right? The big chill's on. Many of you will look for ways to warm up to fight that big chill. Let's get right to My 33's Nefertiti Jacquez, who's been braving the big chill on Miami Beach. Luckily, Nef, you have that scarf.
I know, because a big chill means big scarves, big coats, and big jackets. But at home, George and Danielle, it means using some space heater. So this morning, we have some tips to keep you safe.
As South Florida experiences a cold snap, officials are warning folks about space heater safety. Officials say to reduce the risk of fire, make sure your space heater meets safety requirements and is placed in an area where it can't be knocked over. Do not drape clothes or towels over it. Also, never use space heaters when you are out of a room or asleep. As the mercury drops, homeless people are urged to seek shelter. Special shelters are open in Broward and Miami-Dade County.
As the temperatures drop, more and more people will come in. They'll decide it's too cold to be out on the street.
Back out live, 7:04, 54 degrees. Officials also say people should bring their pets indoors. And as you can see, it's been 54 degrees since we've been out here this morning. So that's 2.5 hours. So that means folks will continue wearing their scarves and staying warm. That is the very latest from South Beach. Nefertiti Jacquez, My 33 News on the Move.
All right, Nef, thank you. Stay warm. 7:04, a South Florida family begins this week planning a funeral for a father and son killed in a crash in Tamarack. Four vehicles piled up on West Commercial Boulevard at the Turnpike overpass. Police say a white Stratus crossed the median, slammed into westbound traffic. The man and boy riding in the Stratus were likely killed on impact. Five people and an infant from other cars were taken to the hospital.
Now let's move on to a story that you saw first right here on 33. The driver who crashed into Shaquille O'Neal's car over the weekend has been charged, and Shaq may be the reason why. He took off after that driver who slammed into his door early Sunday morning and took off. The driver and three passengers say they were leaving Vision Nightclub in Coconut Grove when they hit Shaq's door. They say they got scared and took off. And that's when Shaquille got on their tail and followed them all the way to a gas station on Southwest 17th Avenue and Coral Way, where police questioned everyone involved.
But the car was outside, like in park, and with the lights off, and a black car. And he opened the door, but I don't think he saw us. And he opened the door, and I hit him.
And all of a sudden, we passed, and the car started chasing us. We kept going down. We didn't know what was going on. We just kept going down. We turned. The car's chasing us. We didn't know what was happening.
The Heat star confirmed through a spokesperson that he did indeed follow that car, but he says he followed police procedure. Shaquille is, in fact, a trained reserve officer with the Miami Beach Police. The Miami Heat spokesperson also says when Shaq caught up to them, he immediately called the police, who eventually met everyone at that gas station. One of the passengers said police gave the driver tickets for leaving the scene of an accident and reckless driving.
By next week at this time, we're going to know who won the Super Bowl, and some people are hoping it's them. This morning, the Chicago Bears are in town.
They certainly are. They actually arrived in town yesterday, and My 33's Kim Bocamper was there to greet them as they prepare for the South Florida showdown.
Well, Super Bowl 41 officially gets down to business Sunday. The Bears roll into town, and they are hoping to make their week super. Head coach Lovie Smith leading the way as the Bears touched down at about 4 o'clock yesterday at Miami International. Bears colors waving from the cockpit. Brian Urlacher and the entire Chicago defense going to have their hands full with Peyton Manning and company. There's Rex Grossman. You know, he's going to have pressure on him all week. Now, Sunday's game, that's going to be the classic matchup of brains versus brawn as the monster of the Midway try to ground the high-flying Colts. Whatever way you may want to look at this one, it is strictly about business, though, for the Bears.
It's been a lot of fun this year. We have a super group of players. You'll get a chance to meet a lot of them this week. But it's a business trip for us as much as anything.
All right, the Bears are already settled in down here in South Florida. Later on today, the Colts will be coming down. They're going to practice in Indianapolis, and then they're expected to touch down at 7 p.m. this evening. That's new for sports. I'm Kim Bocamper, My 33 Sports.
All right, our team coverage now continues this morning. One of the hot spots for all of the events happening this week is, of course, South Beach, specifically Catholic House Arena, where the NFL and our sister station CBS4 is setting up camp. My 33's Yusilla Ramirez is there live as well right now with more this morning. Hi, Yusilla.
Good morning, Danielle. All the hard work paying off out here. Super Bowl week is on, and it looks like South Beach is just about ready. Just a couple of other details that crews are working on, but it looks like it's pretty much ready to go. This is going to be the hot spot, especially here at Casa Casa Arena on Ocean and 11th. The NFL is setting up shop right outside. There is plenty planned for this week, so listen up. If you're looking to party the days leading up to the big game, then South Beach is the place to be. Crews have been working nonstop to convert Ocean Drive into the it spot for Super Bowl partiers. Starting this Thursday, Ocean Drive will be shut down from 5th Street to 15th Street for Motorola Mile. On Saturday, Volleypalooza is expected to turn a lot of heads. The beautiful and famous will be hitting the sand for a slamming game of volleyball. The best part, it's free and open to the public. Meanwhile, over at Dolphin Stadium, hundreds of workers have been at it for weeks, dressing up and getting the stadium ready for the Super Bowl, creating the NFL experience and making sure everything is just right. If the tears fall down like rain. And what's a party without music? There'll be plenty of that. To kick off Super Bowl week, Grammy Award winner Hootie and the Blowfish will be playing at the Seminole Hard Rock Casino tonight. Back out here live at Casa Casa Arena, Ocean and 11th. There will be a huge party out here. And as I mentioned before, the NFL is setting up shop. We'll also be setting up shop out here, and live, look for live coverage starting on Thursday here, CBS 4 and My 33. You can also log on to our sister station's website, CBS4.com, for the latest on the lineup this week. And of course, we'll be there and for the big game on Sunday. That's the very latest on South Beach. Yusilla Ramirez, My 33 News on the Move.
Yusilla, thanks. So here is a quick look at the big events happening today as we start our countdown to the big game. The Chicago Bears will hold a news conference featuring coach Lovie Smith and quarterback Rex Grossman. Then in the early evening, the AFC champion Indianapolis Colts arrive at Fort Lauderdale Hollywood International Airport. Kim Bocamper will be there live. And tonight, let the parties begin. The official kickoff for Super Bowl week gets underway with opening ceremonies at the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. Our very own Lisa Petrillo will take you there. Stay with My 33 and our sister station CBS4 for all the exclusive coverage. Be sure to log on to CBS4.com and check out our special Super Bowl section for all the events going on across South Florida. You can even see a preview of some of the commercials that could run during the big game. And of course, you can watch that game on our sister station CBS4 on February 4th. That, of course, is this Sunday.
Now let's get the latest inside Iraq at 7:10. Iraqi officials estimate as many as 300 militants died in a day-long battle with U.S.-backed Iraqi troops. The insurgents were allegedly plotting to kill pilgrims at a major Shiite religious festival. Here in the U.S., though, demonstrators against the war plan to flood congressional offices today to lobby for a troop withdrawal.
This morning, Prince Charles and his wife Camilla head back to the United States, back to the United Kingdom after a whirlwind trip here in the United States. The royal couple first stopped in Philadelphia and then visited New York City, where the Prince of Wales received an award for his work on behalf of the environment. Sunday's itinerary also included a stop at the Promise Academy in Harlem, where the pair saw some of the charter school programs in action.
7-Eleven right now, coming up this morning, out for a walk 1 minute, mauled by a mountain lion the next. The amazing way this man fought back.
And take a look at this. A news crew winds up in deep, icy water, how their van went under. Plus, you'll never imagine the story they were covering when all of this happened.
Plus, dishing the dirt, Katie Holmes' maternity leave isn't costing her choice of film parts. We're going to tell you why the actress is choosing to pass on a guaranteed blockbuster that would pay her millions. Keep watching.
Did you know that 38 million Americans experience hunger or are at risk of hunger?
And the U.S. has the highest child poverty rate of any other industrialized nation.
But did you also know that $1 can provide 8 meals to hungry people? This Super Bowl weekend, South Floridians will work together to fight hunger in our community.
Through the Super Bowl of Caring, you can help $1 at a time.
One person can make a difference. Please join the team.
Tides are definitely turning.
Trust me, this is something you won't want to miss.
This week on Wicked Wicked Games.
When is it going to be enough for you?
Never.
Don't miss the fun.
It's hard not to get carried away when all your dreams are coming true.
Then on Watch Over Me.
You're the best thing that's ever happened to me, and I'm not going to let you slip away.
She thought she could trust him. She thought wrong.
He's killed people, Julia.
On My Network TV. It all starts tonight at 8 on My 33.
When I signed up for Vonage, I was able to keep my phone number, and then when I moved, I was able to take it with me.
Call quality is the utmost. It projects my business. And with Vonage, it's perfect.
Vonage and reliability, that just kind of goes hand in hand.
It's just $24.99 a month for unlimited local and long distance calling, including free calls to Canada and Europe.
Get 1 month free. Call 1-800-397-0164.
Vonage, a better way to phone for less.
What's important to me is price. I want to know I got the best price, and I did.
Definitely relationship. I like that they make me feel like a VIP.
What's important to us is you, our customer. At Esserman International, it's all about you.
At Esserman International, you can lease a brand new 2007 VW Jetta for only $179 per month. Accelerate your way to luxury and style for only $179 per month.
Esserman International, donde regalito al International Mall.
A California man's telling his shocking story of survival after he was mauled by a mountain lion.
Take a look. 70-year-old Jim Hamm is in the hospital recovering this morning. He's undergone surgery to repair cuts to his face and his upper body. He and his wife were hiking in Northern California when that lion jumped on top of him. That's when they both fought back and managed to scare it away.
I get my pin from my pocket. So I went in my pants pocket and jam it in his eye. So she jammed it in his eye and it crumbled. So it wouldn't work. So she got the club and started to club it again. She did that and it backed off and laid his ears back. And she was yelling and screaming at him. And it just turned around and went off into the ferns and left.
Well, doctors aren't sure when Ham will be released from the hospital. A television news crew in Wisconsin got themselves in a troublesome situation. Take a look at that. Police say the driver of a news truck mistook part of a lake for the road. Hard to believe, but the crew was actually covering a story about ice safety. Fortunately, no one was hurt, but the truck is still in the lake. No word on when it will be removed.
You know, somebody got in trouble for that.
I would just use that as part of the piece. We meant to do that.
Only cost us, what, $700,000 for the truck, but whatever. It is 7:15 right now. We have a traffic alert, actually, to get to. Chopper 33 over the scene. Hey, Mark.
Hey, good morning. Well, this is taking a live look here from Chopper 33 over Northwest 199th Street eastbound at Northwest 52nd Avenue. Got an overturned vehicle. There are some injuries involved, and 199th Street is closed at this point. Miami Gardens Drive probably going to be better alternate for you at this time, but you can see a lot of activity still in the area. This happened about 45 minutes ago, and hopefully they'll be getting this cleared up real soon, and the injuries hopefully are not too extreme. Now, again, 199th Street is shut down. You want to use Miami Gardens as your alternate. Also taking a look at 95 north and southbound around the Golden Glades. If you're heading southbound right now, a little smoke down there by the pedestrian bridge. Hope everything's okay. But other than that, everything looks like it's moving along okay northbound. Southbound, you're going to have to give yourself a little bit extra time between 151st and all the way down to about 62nd Street. You may still want to consider 441 as your southbound alternate. Live from Traffic Control, I'm Mark Henry, My 33 News on the Move.
Thank you, Mark. It is 7:16. Let's get you out to meteorologist Craig Setzer right now.
Craig, so pretty cold out there.
So it is pretty cold out there, but part of our big chill, this is just the little chill ahead of the bigger chill, which is coming tonight. 55 right now. This is our XLI cam. Ooh, cool, huh? There's the stadium. Sunday's the day. And the forecast right now is looking warm with a chance for showers. 80 degrees, so let's just hope it's not a rainy evening right now. A little hard to tell, pinpoint when the rain would be if it comes on Sunday, but at least it's looking warmer than it is right now. Here's a look at temperatures across South Florida. Most readings in the low to mid 50s from north to south, east to west. Everybody enjoying a nice, cool, crisp, refreshing January morning. Up to the north, it is even colder. Look at that, 28s coming in from Jacksonville and Tallahassee, as well as Pensacola. And the reason we're talking about these temperatures up here is because a wind is from the northwest. It's pulling that cold air down. It's also pulling very dry air down, humidity levels in the 40 to 50% range up in here. And that dry air is going to mean very, very dry air by afternoon once the sun warms the air up just a little bit. And that means the fire danger is going to be extremely high for today, so keep that in mind. Cold front pushed through yesterday. Northwest winds now bringing that cooler air in, and it's going to stick around through tonight. Our 2V for today showing plenty of sunshine. It'll be cool sunshine, though, and even colder tonight with lows dropping into the 40s, even some 30s possible, and some patchy frost is possible also west and northern outlying areas. For tomorrow, chilly start and then a little bit warmer, a high near 72 degrees, and then for Wednesday, warmer yet. The high moves off to the east. Our winds finally start to shift to more of an easterly direction, so a beach breeze and starting to warm up beginning on Wednesday. If you're traveling over the southeast today, no weather problems from in terms of delays, temperatures in the 40s and 50s. In the northeast, though, could be some delays, especially this morning. Some snow this morning moving away, but some flurries will be left over. Temperatures in the 30s and 20s for highs, a chilly 26 in Chicago, 23 in Pittsburgh, and on the west coast, it's mostly quiet. West coast in the mountains, temperatures 30s in the mountains and 40s and 50s, even some 60s in the southwest. Our forecast for today, call it Sunshine City. That's where we live in, Sunshine City. Chilly start, high temperature near 66 under that sunshine. If you're boating, big seas, especially in the Gulf Stream, up to 12 feet with that northwest wind. Tonight, from Sunshine City, it's Chillyville. Coldest readings inland, some patchy frost possible north and west sections, lows upper 30s to upper 40s. And then here we go through the rest of the week. We'll be into warm metro land or something like that. Temperatures from the 60s back into the 80s. This will just be a cool memory. Back to you cool guys.
Well, thanks, Craig. That's a nice little dip and then back up to 80.
Back up to normal.
It's what we do well here.
Normal?
Yeah. I meant 80, but sure, we can do normal well. 7:19 right now, coming up on this Monday. Feeling a little groggy? That's normal for a Monday. The breakthrough doctors have come up with in the mission to help you get your sleep.
And posting video on the internet site YouTube could mean big bucks. We'll tell you why users might soon cash in when My 33 News on the Move returns. Stay with us.
Tamo, hello. I invite you to the 36th Annual Seminole Tribe of Florida Fair, Powwow, and Rodeo, February 8th through the 11th. Come experience Native American culture at its best. See the always exciting powwow dancers, buy some handmade crafts, or indulge in some Seminole fry bread. The Seminole Tribe of Florida's Powwow and Rodeo will be held in the Hard Rock Live at Seminole Paradise, located on the premises of the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino in beautiful Hollywood, Florida. This year's event is free to the public, so bring your family and friends and spend the day with us. Shanabish.
If you're looking for the biggest selection of RC cars and trucks, then step into Warwick's Hobby Superstore. Don't you have anything bigger than this? Now we're talking. Warwick's has super fast race cars, super sport buggies, and dirt flinging trucks, plus a huge selection of the coolest watercraft you've ever seen. You think I'd be better at this by now? On land or sea, for any kind of RC fun, race into Warwick's Hobby Superstore.
Sam finds brushing boring. My secret weapon? Ha-ha! Listerine Agent Cool Blue.
Cool.
It turns the plaque on Sam's teeth blue, because when he can see the plaque, he can brush more effectively. And because it's from Listerine, it kills bad breath germs, too. Better brushing means a cleaner mouth.
Sam, nice work.
And a happier mom. This case is closed.
Listerine Agent Cool Blue for kids.
What's cool is how they'll love to brush.
February 7th is National Black HIV AIDS Awareness Day. Take a minute to find out how HIV and AIDS affects you and your family, because being aware means being safe. To learn more, visit WeMakeTheChange.com or call 1-800-FLA-AIDS.
.721 the time right now in Dr. Sean's medical file this morning. A calorie is, well, just a calorie. That's what researchers say they've discovered after testing overweight people looking to shed some pounds.
They found eating less and exercising more are equally good at keeping off the weight. The study showed no way to selectively lose belly fat or trim the thighs, challenging some approaches of the multi-billion dollar diet and fitness industry.
Swiss researchers say they may have discovered a new way to help insomniacs get some shut eye. The researchers have been studying a disease that causes people to suddenly drop off to sleep. They found that blocking certain brain receptors promoted sleep in rats, dogs, and people. Now scientists are testing a drug that will block these receptors.
Top cancer specialists say more money needs to go towards lung cancer, particularly how it affects women. A number of studies have found that female smokers seem to be more likely than males to develop lung cancer. More women die from lung cancer than they do from breast, ovarian, and uterine cancers combined.
Well, 7:22 is the time right now. Coming up next for you this morning, it is cold outside. We have a warning you have to hear before you turn on your space heater.
Then uploading videos onto YouTube could mean big bucks, why users might soon be cashing in.
Plus, of course, we're going to dish the dirt for you here on This Money, from comic spoofs to bumbling hitmen. We'll tell you who's laughing all the way to the bank after this weekend's box office. Stay with us.
A chef named Alfredo invented the sauce, but Papa John's perfected it on pizza. Try Papa John's Spinach Alfredo Pizza with a creamy spinach garlic parmesan Alfredo sauce for just $11.99. Or say make it a deluxe and add bacon, fresh sliced onions, and baby portobello mushrooms at no additional charge. Call now or order online at PapaJohns.com and we'll deliver.
Taste the difference. Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's.
Football fans, step off the sidelines and get into the game. The NFL experience built by the Home Depot is coming to Dolphin Stadium. Take part in Pro Football's interactive theme park with over 50 games, exhibits, and attractions included in one price of admission. The whole family can throw a pass, announce plays, field a punt, or dive into the end zone to score the winning touchdown. Tickets are $15 for adults, $10 for kids under 12. Call 866-KICKS-4-NFL or log on to SuperBowl.com to get your tickets. This is your Super Bowl.
City Furniture has a spectacular selection of microfiber sofas in stock.
Microfiber fabrics are naturally stain resistant and easy to care for. Microfibers feel soft and plush to the touch, yet are incredibly durable.
Plus, City Furniture now offers same day delivery, 7 days a week, and no payments for one full year.
With more than 80,000 people in Broward receiving food stamps and Miami-Dade's affordable housing crisis, South Florida needs your help. Hi, I'm My33's Jennifer Santiago. Neighbors for Neighbors is teaming up with Super Bowl of Caring to fight hunger and poverty. Imperial Models will be taking donations at Ocean Drive Magazine's Vollypalooza on Saturday, February 3rd. For details, call 305-597-4404.
If you see news in the making, dial star My33 on your Metro PCS cellular phone.
It is 7:25 on Monday. Time to dish the dirt.
First up, let's talk movies. Spoof comedies don't win Oscar gold, but they do make lots of money at the box office. Mm-hmm. Epic Movie, which lampoons dozens of films, a few MTV shows, and Paris Hilton, came in at number one at the box office this weekend, bringing in over $19 million, just like the Scary Movie series did, I guess. Second place, the violent dark comedy Smokin' Aces came in at number two, $14 million on that one. And still holding strong at the top three, the comedy Night at the Museum featuring Ben Stiller with more than $9 million.
The King and Queen reigned supreme at the 13th annual Screen Actors Guild Awards last night. Helen Mirren took home Best Actress for The Queen, while Forrest Whitaker nabbed Best Actor for The Last King of Scotland, reinforcing their status as Oscar frontrunners, as well as Eddie Murphy and Jennifer Hudson, who won supporting acting SAG honors for Dreamgirls. The road trip tale, Little Miss Sunshine, won the prize for Best Film Ensemble, the Guild's equivalent to a Best Picture Award.
Let's talk about Katie Holmes.
Yes.
She's choosing quality over quantity for her return to the big screen. The younger half of Tomcat has turned down close to $2 million to reprise her role in The Dark Knight, the sequel to Batman Returns. Holmes has instead signed on to appear in a flick called Mad Money, an all-female comedy caper, which Us Weekly reports pays a measly $250,000. Because she was the female lead in Batman Begins.
But I have to say, and maybe it's coming from our perspective, which is a little different than Tomcat, but there's nothing measly
about $250,000.
Yeah. I'll take it.
Well, she needs to be taken as a serious actress, especially now that she's become such tabloid fodder and all that stuff.
Yeah. All right. 7:27 is the time right now. There's still plenty more dirt we want to dish for you. Coming up next, a little bit more about this guy you see behind us here, Eddie Murphy. Is he scared of going overseas? Coming up at 8, we'll tell you why the Oscar-nominated actor may be avoiding trips to England.
So 6 hours on a plane. We'll be right back.
Oh, no, I think that's an easy.
Every day, Progressive does something that's, well, progressive. They have this ticker that shows their car insurance rates and their top competitors. Right now on Progressive.com, you can see actual rates that people are getting. Sometimes Progressive is the lowest, sometimes they're not. Hey, if they're this helpful when you're shopping for car insurance, imagine how they'll be once you're a customer.
The South Florida Super Bowl Host Committee presents the Super Celebration Series. First, a salute to South Florida's Super Tradition. Monday, January 29th at the Seminole Hard Rock Live Arena with Hootie and the Blowfish. Willie Torino, Styx and Maze featuring Frankie Beverly. Headline the Super Saturday Blast on Biscayne on the eve of the Super Bowl. For a list of all Super Celebration Series events, log on to SuperBowlXLI.org. The South Florida Super Bowl Host Committee would like to thank its official partners.
Coming up on the King of Queens.
The canoe.
Doug and Carrie are up the creek without a paddle.
Get me a helicopter now.
Tonight at 7 on My33. Tonight on My33 News at 10. Debit cards, they're a shopper's best friend. But if you're not careful, you could get hit with some big fees. Find out how to protect your money when paying with plastic. Tonight on My33 News at 10. Now, live, this is My33 News on the Move.
A new half hour starts right now. I'm George Estevez.
And I'm Danielle Knox. Good to be with you as always this morning. You're watching My33 News on the Move. Mark Tyler Henry has his eyes on the roadways. What do you see, Mark?
Hey, good morning. Well, actually, not a whole lot going on out there. Luckily, we're having a pretty light accident day, but congestion's getting to be a bit of a concern right now. 95 north and southbound right around the Cypress Creek Road here. Southbound lane, you're probably going to be hitting the brakes around Commercial. Northbound, probably a little bit slow around Atlantic Boulevard. But other than that, pretty wide open road for you. Also taking a look at 95 north and southbound around the Golden Glades Interchange, both directions here. Moving along okay. Southbound lane's a little bit draggy right now between 151st and 79th Street. Northbound lane's getting by without too many problems at all. And our old friend the Palmetto, you can just kind of see it through the haze there. Southbound lane's between the big curve and the airport. Pretty heavily traveled right now. You may want to head on over to the Turnpike as your southbound alternate. Live from Traffic Control, I'm Mark Henry, My 33 News on the Move.
From traffic, we go to weather, where it is chilly, but that's not all.
What else is there, Craig?
It's light. The sun is starting to come up.
The sunrise.
Ding, 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 ding. That's correct. 10 points. Temperatures in the low to mid-50s across much of South Florida this morning. It is chilly, but that's not all, as George said, because it's also very dry out there, so the fire danger is going to be very high, and it's going to get even colder tonight. So these readings, which are chilly, that's nothing compared to what's coming. Temperatures across Broward, as you see, are in the 50s, low 50s, low to mid-50s also in Dade. Already temperatures have bottomed out for today, but they're not going to warm a whole lot, thanks to the cold front that passed through yesterday. Cool air, northwest winds, and very dry air is pushing down the peninsula. So the fire danger today is going to be extremely high, and then tonight we're going to be colder. In fact, a freeze watch is in effect for the Everglades portion of Broward County. So that's pretty much well west of Weston and the metro areas. 39 forecast in Weston, 40 in Margate, 42 in Sunrise, 43 in Miramar, and low to mid 40s along coastal sections of Broward. And a cold morning for tomorrow morning, that's tonight and tomorrow. Also in Dade, temperatures in the 40s, even some upper 30s in outlying areas, and some patchy frost is possible. For today though, our forecast calling for, after a chilly start, Sunshine City, high temperature near 66, and our warming trend gets underway tomorrow. I'll have more on that coming up in a bit.
All right, Craig, thanks. Here are your top stories for this half hour. This morning, a South Florida family begins the week planning for a funeral for their father and son killed in a crash in Tamarack.
That's right. Four vehicles, in fact, piled up on West Commercial Boulevard at the Turnpike overpass. Police say a white Stratus crossed the median and slammed into westbound traffic. The man and boy riding in that Stratus were likely killed on impact. Five people and one infant from other cars were taken to area hospitals.
A driver who crashed into Shaquille O'Neal's SUV over the weekend has been charged, and Shaq may be the reason why. The driver and three passengers say they were leaving this club, Vision Nightclub in the Grove, when they hit Shaq's car, the door. They say they got scared and took off, and that's when Shaq, who's a reserve Miami Beach officer, got on their tail, followed them all the way to a gas station on Southwest 17th Avenue in Coral Way. He then called police, who showed up and ticketed the driver.
Iraqi officials estimate as many as 300 militants died in a day-long battle near Najaf with U.S.-backed Iraqi troops. The insurgents were allegedly plotting to kill pilgrims at a major Shiite religious festival. In Washington, demonstrators against the war plan to flood congressional offices today to lobby for troop withdrawal.
Winter may have come late to South Florida, but it's here right now.
It certainly is. And with the big chill in the air, many of you will be looking for ways to warm up. Let's get right to My 33's Nefertiti Jacquez, who joins us live from Miami Beach. And part of that warm-up, Nef, includes space heaters.
Yeah, I know. And people have to be safe with those. And you can imagine, it is so cold out here. It is 54 degrees due to that up there. And in South Beach, you're thinking, So with space heaters, of course, folks trying to keep warm inside of their home, officials have a couple of tips and warnings for folks in order to keep safe. They say to reduce the risk of fire, make sure that your space heater meets safety requirements, that it's placed in an area where it can't be knocked over. Make sure not to drape clothes or towels over it. Also, never use space heaters when you're in another room or if you've fallen asleep or you know you're about to fall asleep. Definitely disconnect that from the wall there. And these are all important tips, because you got to make sure that you and your family are safe. As we come back out live again to South Beach, it is 55 degrees now, so it's a degree up since we first started, but that's still really cold. So, you know, until that stays that cold, South Floridians will be bundling up, even the folks on South Beach. Who would have ever thought? That is the very latest from South Beach. Nefertiti Jacquez, My 33 News on the Move.
Thanks, Neff. It is 7:34, and a family in Fort Lauderdale is devastated this morning after their five-year-old is discovered at the bottom of a pool. The little boy's grandmother called police after Javon Hawley fell into that pool at her home on Northwest 15th Place on Saturday. An officer jumped into the pool and actually had to feel his way around because the water was so murky. He eventually found that child in the deep end, pulled him out of the water. The child was rushed to Broward General Medical Center, where he was pronounced dead just a short time later.
A suspected drunk driver is facing some serious charges after leading cops on a high-speed chase. Police say Carl Gonzalez hit two FHP troopers as he flew through a DUI checkpoint on I-95 in downtown Miami Saturday. Cops took off after him for miles. During the chase, Gonzalez hit two police cruisers before finally coming to a stop. Both troopers were treated on the scene for cuts and bruises.
This morning, we know the names of both the victim and the suspect in a murder outside a Hollywood school. Police have identified the victim as 40-year-old Kathleen Worrell of Sebastian, and they say they have arrested 26-year-old Jonathan Gallo of Coconut Creek for the crime. A woman walking her dog Saturday found Worrell's partially clothed and beaten body in front of Oak Ridge Elementary School.
Because the police were not this end, they were the other end of the street, so I actually saw the body on the sidewalk.
And police say they were tipped off by Gallo's own girlfriend, who told them he'd come home covered in blood. Police say during questioning, he confessed.
7:36. A South Florida community comes together to push for peace after a teenager was shot and left to die in his father's arms. Garvin Webster's family and friends took part in this peace rally over the weekend. It was on Northwest 35th Street in Miami. Garvin's father says he hears of murders all too often.
You know, everywhere all over town, you're hearing the same thing. They shot this one today, they shot this one yesterday. So today we just get in together to see what can be done about it.
Police have arrested and charged 16-year-old Tyree Patrick Walker for the murder of Webster's son, Garvin.
7:36 is the time right now. Coming up next this morning, we, of course, are counting down to Super Bowl showdowns right here in South Florida. From the exclusive parties to the team arrivals, we have everything you need to know to navigate your way around the big game.
Yes. Also, this story coming up, uploading your videos on the internet site YouTube could mean big bucks for you. Why users are now cashing in.
Plus, you don't want to miss how this feathered friend survived not one, not two, but three near-death experiences.
Plus, traffic can be stressful, but can it turn you into another person? Let's talk about it in today's web poll. Listen up. This is Music with Who Knows. To a place where our emotions can grow if we let them go. 'Cause who knows what may happen if we act bold. Our attractions and lose ourselves inside of world.
If you've been in a car accident, you need to listen. According to Florida law, you're entitled to a minimum of $10,000 in personal injury protection and lost wages, whether the accident is your fault or not. 1-800-411-PAIN provides accident help start to finish. They take emergency calls from home or hospital 24/7. Car damage, they even provide free transportation. Call today to see how much you're entitled to. In any accident, call 1-800-411-PAIN.
What's important to me is price. I want to know I got the best price, and I did.
Definitely relationship. I like that they make me feel like a VIP.
What's important to us is you, our customer. At Esserman International, it's all about you.
At Esserman International, you can lease a brand new 2007 VW Jetta for only $179 per month. Accelerate your way to luxury and style for only $179 per month.
Esserman International, donde regalito al International Mall.
Mom says there's no money for college.
Then do what I did. I took a medical assisting program.
Yeah, but how long did it take?
Less time than I thought. They even placed me in an externship program. That's how I met Dr. Radley. Look, why don't you give them a call and have them send you an information package?
I think Mom's gonna like this.
Call Florida Metropolitan University for information at 800-515-9498. That's 800-515-9498. Call now or check us out online at fmu-info.com.
Boom. Hey, I thought you were supposed to be full time.
Not feeling it.
You're not feeling it, huh?
Yeah, that's what I said.
How long till you rise?
A couple minutes.
Plenty of time.
Oh, yeah.
I'm full. Thanks, son.
The day begins with a happy breakfast. Delicious Jimmy Dean sandwiches. Real breakfast, real fast.
7:39, let's give you a tease of what you can expect out on the roadways. Here's Mark Tyler, Henry. Mark?
Well, we'll tease you, but I don't think you're going to like it too much. Taking a look at the Palmetto, if you're heading southbound or you happen to be thinking about heading southbound right now, between anywhere between the big curve and the airport, a lot of stop and go. Looks like it might be moving a little bit there, but that could be deceiving. That road can just back up at any moment. Northbound lane's getting by without too many problems at all, so if you're heading northbound, just consider yourself lucky. Southbound, you might want to think about taking the turnpike. Also taking a look right now at 95 north and southbound around the Golden Glades. Somebody got pulled over there, might be getting a ticket or something. We're not going to try to stare at them, though. Southbound lanes between 151st and 62nd Street, lots of stop and go there. Might want to think about 441 as your southbound alternate. Northbound lanes getting by without too many problems. And also taking a look at 95 north and southbound right around Cypress Creek Road. Looking like a pretty easy ride southbound. Might be hitting the brakes a little bit around Commercial. Northbound lanes actually looks like you're getting a little bit heavy as you approach Atlantic and Sample. But again, no crashes or accidents to worry about at this time. And if you want to find out where all the crashes, accidents, and all the good roads are in the afternoon, log on to CBS4.com. Get all your live rush hour ride updates and make that ride home a little bit easier. CBS4.com, where the news is always on.
It is 7:41 right now, and not today. Today's not the day you have to go out and warm up your car.
No, but maybe tomorrow?
Yeah,
maybe?
Craig Setzer's going to tell us about that. Hey, Craig, remember those days?
Yeah. It's definitely a car warm-up day for South Floridians. Now, I know visitors up north go, what?
Exactly.
What are you talking about? But for us little thin-blooded people here, it's cold out there. 55 right now is a common number across South Florida. Live picture from our second tower cam showing lots of sunshine. So if you get in the sun and out of the breeze, it's going to feel great. But if you're in the shade, it's going to feel a little bit cool by South Florida standards. Here's what's going on temperature-wise. Temperatures in the low to mid-50s from north to south. Some of the coolest readings outline sections, and that's what we'll see again tonight, where a light frost is possible. So you're going to want to do things today to protect plants and bring your pets inside if they normally live outside. They're not used to this cold. 20s in North Florida, 30s in the middle of the state, 40s farther south. Look at that, a 41 in Tampa. And a 28 in Jacksonville, 50s over South Florida, 64 in Key West. Another story today is going to be the fire danger, which will be extremely high. The reason? Very dry air up in the northern and central parts of the peninsula. We'll be pushing our way through the day today. Humidity levels this afternoon around the 30% range, so desert dryness, and that usually sets the stage this time of year for high fire danger. Cold front moved through yesterday. It's on out of here, so nothing but cold air coming in, or at least cool air. So our forecast, our true view for today, calling for cool sunshine, even colder tonight. The 50s this morning will be replaced by 40s tonight and even some 30s in some spots. And then as we go into Tuesday, after a chilly start to the day, things will start to warm up with mostly sunny skies still, but more of an onshore flow, northeast breezes. So that'll push the temperatures into the 70s Tuesday and mid-70s for Wednesday. Beach breeze continue to warm up, and by Thursday, we could be back to near 80 degrees and mid-80s by Friday. If you're traveling over the southeast this morning, no problems from the weather. Temperatures in the 40s and 50s and lots of dry conditions. In the northeast, some morning snow may have made for some delays there, but just some leftover flurries now. Temperatures 20s and 30s also in the upper Midwest. Some 20s there for highs. And in the west, it's mostly quiet. Temperatures fairly typical for this time of year. Here's our forecast for today. We are living in Sunshine City. A chilly start to the day, 66 for the high. For tonight, we're going to Chillyville with the coldest readings inland, patchy frost north and west. Temperatures upper 30s to upper 40s. The rest of the week, not looking too bad. It is Mildnessville City, town, something like that. Temperatures back into the 80s by Thursday and Friday. I'm done.
Mildville. I like that.
Mildville.
As opposed to cool. See, I had the same problem he did.
Yeah, that's true.
Coolburg.
There we
like
go.
Like it.
All right. 7:44.
Yeah. We did the web poll on Friday. Want to see how everybody weighed in on that. Here's what we asked. We asked you, you know, regardless of how offensive it may be, do you feel officials have the right to ban a word? All of this springs, of course, from a town looking to ban the N-word. Well, 21% of you said yes, while 79% of you said no, and we did get some email on this. I want to read this one from Jamel Arnold, and he says, hi, crew.
Hey, crew.
That means you.
Right, crew.
This is regarding the web poll from Friday. I don't think officials have the right to ban a word. I agree that some words may be offensive, but officials must leave it to the citizens to have enough tolerance to decide not to use inappropriate words. Also, we have the right to free speech in the Constitution. Great point.
Good stuff. All right, we got a couple of other emails that talk about you.
Oh.
And your pregnancy.
Oh.
Because she's pregnant. Don't know if you know. This is from Yessie R.
Hi, Yessie.
Hi, Danielle. Ever consider having your baby in a birth center? She says she had her first baby and it was a beautiful experience. At first, she thought she couldn't do it. They teach you how to deal with the pain, though, because there are no drugs or anesthesia.
Well, you lost me.
Right. Good for you, Yessie, though. I thought I couldn't do it, but they taught you. Maybe you guys can read up on it, do a segment on the different ways to birth a baby, hospitals versus birth centers.
I remember doing a story a few years ago, Yessie, on a birth center, and I think it's such a great experience because you're right. They teach you breathing and how to breathe through the pain and that kind of thing. But I can't do it for a couple of reasons. One is that this is my third child, and I've had two C-sections, and so this is going to be a C-section.
Right.
And then the other reason is that my threshold for pain?
None.
It's there, but it's quite low.
But women have a higher threshold for pain than
men.
And
I think, you know what I think, too? I think when you're in that situation,
what?
All of a sudden your threshold increases.
What situation?
Labor.
Oh, right. That situation.
What was that?
Something just fell. I have no idea. All right, so people might like it. The past 2 years have been a baby boom.
I think that's a great, good story to do, too.
Yeah, so good luck, Danielle.
Thanks, Yessie.
All right, this one. It says, Pamela, George, Danielle, you guys do a great job with the morning news. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
The crew works as a team and real people, and we don't come across as celebrity newscasters. So there we go. Great to see nice, friendly, real personalities in the morning. Thank you so much for your hard work, is what Ronald Diaz has written to us.
That was a nice email from Ronald.
And then Ronald goes on to say,
uh-oh.
Danielle.
Yes, Ronald.
You look beautiful. Love to see your belly grow. When are you due?
Oh, it is growing and moving, and I'm due March 21st.
It moved. She moved. We haven't really discussed what it is.
No,
but it moved earlier, and it was movement.
And it freaked him out.
A little bit.
No, yeah. No, so, March 21st. Well, my due date is April 2nd, but I'm having a C-section on March 21st.
That's got to be the best when you can pick your own day.
Makes it a lot easier.
What if you're not in the mood that day? Can you, like, do the next day?
No, sweetie. I think it's already
just checking.
Yeah, pre-planned.
All right. What about today's web poll?
You know, this is an interesting thing, because last week, actually, I was driving home from work.
Okay.
And I'm driving home, you know, minding my own business, and there was a car that wanted to get over into my lane, but that car did not put on his blinker. He just kind of felt like if he nudged his way over, I'd let him over. But I didn't have the space to slow down because there was a car behind me to let him over.
Okay.
So I didn't. I just kept driving my normal speed. He sped up, whipped around me.
Sped up to catch you.
Sped up to go around me, because he needed to make a left-hand turn.
Uh-huh.
Whipped around me, rolled down his window, and flipped me off.
Wow. There was a hand gesture involved.
There was
not
a
so
hand,
nice
gesture
hand gesture
involving one of his fingers. And I thought about this guy, and I said, you know, because what I said to him was when he rolled down his window to flip me off, I rolled down my window and said, have a nice day.
Oh, kill him with kindness.
Kill him with kindness. And so that led me to think about...
Because what you could have done was...
Was what?
No, that wouldn't
have been
right.
I know what you would have done.
No!
Huh? Come on.
Whatever.
Does your personality change, though, when you get behind the wheel? You could be this nice, innocent, unassuming person.
Because that's probably who he was.
Yeah.
Something else just fell. That's probably what he was.
But then as soon as you get behind the wheel, do you find that your personality changes, whether for the good or the bad? Are you a kinder person behind the wheel, or are you a meaner person behind the wheel? That's what we want to know from you today. What are you?
I am definitely now becoming a kinder person.
What do you mean now becoming?
Because as you get older, you realize it's not worth getting upset. It's not worth gesturing to other drivers. It's not worth getting mad and maybe using foul language. Because at the end of the moment, that driver's going to go about
and
his or her way.
And you're going to go your way.
But, and they may have a weapon. So, quite frankly, I should not involve myself with people who may have guns.
Which is sad, the fact that, that could be the case. But, no, that's what we want you to answer. And we're interested in your email and your stories about...
Hold on. What about you?
Oh, I probably am...
Uh-oh, I'm feeling something coming here.
A little more defensive.
Right.
Behind the wheel. Because a lot of times I have my kids with me in the back seat, and I feel like, oh, no, you didn't.
Right. So you're not going to be like an offensive driver where you're not going to chase some guy and then give him an attitude for it.
Oh, God, no. I wouldn't do that.
So you just defend your property.
I defend my...
And the children.
The children.
Soon to be three children.
Yes.
Got a question? Want to drop us a line? Log on to 33mytv.com. Click on Answer the My 33 web poll. Does your personality change behind the wheel? Log on and give us a story, because something, I know, something happened to you, probably in the past week, out there on the roads.
What do you mean? Yesterday,
that you would have
morning.
A story to share with us. So we want to make sure that you log on to 33MyTV and share your experience with us.
All right. The time right now is 7:49. We're going to share this break with you, and we'll be right back.